In this video, I will show you how to select surfaces, lines, points as reference directly in the run screen of your MC1 solution. First, we will start with the surface. But before we start to select any reference, you need to have your project loaded and selected your models as being referenceable. This video will not cover these topics, but you can find other videos included in our playlist that will explain these topics. We start in the run screen, and we have two surfaces loaded here. Surfaces are used everywhere where we want to create contours. So it could be a road, it could be a trench, it could be a pond, it could be anything where we want to reference to a surface or create a surface. To reference to those, you tap and hold on the run screen and you open the reference selection menu. First we have height reference, then we have site reference and navigate to point. We start with talking about the height reference. We have two options for height references. We have under tool point. Under tool point is used for surfaces. And under tool point interact or reference to the surface that are closest to the tool point. As you can see right now, we are interacting with this surface. If we rotate our machine, so our tool point comes closer to the other surface, it will automatically change surfaces. And we go back and we interact with the first surface. Under tool point is a very user-friendly functionality for dealing with surfaces. If you are slightly more advanced or have the need for it, you can manually select the surfaces you would like to engage or interact with. Here you have the files, and you can expand the files until you have the specific corridors or surfaces that you manually select. And now our tool point will only reference to this manually selected specific surface and not interact with any other surface, regardless where it might be. I believe that the feature under tool point will cover 98% of the most common workflows or use cases you might have, so we will go back to that one. The next height reference I would like to explain is Autosnap to point and line. That's this functionality here. The models we have loaded right now do not have any lines and points, so I'll just load one. For the simplicity of this demonstration, I disable the surfaces and only load the line one. You can see that we have a file containing lines and points. If we want to reference to them, we open the Select Reference menu, and you can see that we are already now have the auto snap to point and line turned on, which means that we automatically snap to the line that are closest to our tool point. Let me demonstrate. If I rotate my machine, we automatically snap to that line that are now closest. Rotate the other direction, we snap to that line. This feature will be very useful when working with utility, so excavating for drainage, sewage, rainwater, or electric cables. If you have the need for it, also here you can go in and expand the layers in your file and select specific lines that you would like to engage. Let's go to site reference. Site reference is really used to make sure that we have the right placement of the object, if that is a pipe or electric cable. When we go to the site reference menu, we have three options. No site reference, that your site reference is the same as your height reference, or auto snap to point or line. Auto snap to point and line is the exact same functionality as you have, as I just explained you, under the height reference. I highly recommend, for the simplicity, to keep your sight reference as being the same as your height reference. Also here in sight reference, you can, if you are more advanced, select the specific line you would like to use as a sight reference. But as I said, I recommend, for simplicity, to have the same sight reference as your height reference. What will this do for you? The sight reference will give you the indication in the top of the screen how many meters you have sideways to the line that you want to interact or want to excavate to. You can see that we come closer, and when we are green, it means that the height tool point and the sight tool point is within tolerances of the line we want to excavate to. And in this example, the line is in the same elevation as we have right now, so only 40 centimeters below. But let's assume that this was 6 meters below the line that we want to reach. Then the vertical blue line in your cross-section view becomes very handy. That's it. This is how you reference to a surface or to a line and point model. And you can use it when you do contours, parking lots, roads, trenches, ponds, or when you work with line work that you would normally use for utilities such as drainage, electric cables, sewage or rainwater. Thank you for watching.